The program is called Sirpam Pesugirathu. This program will more talk about the temples and its significance. We have come to the place called Uthiramerur, which is in Tamil Nadu, nearby Chengalpattu. This is the place where a beautiful temple has been built during the period of Pallava, where we have come for the program. This is the program specially made for the importance of the temples and its significance. Let me go to the temple inside. Built by Dandi Varma Pallava, 9th century AD. After Dandi Varma Pallava, many kings were developed this temple with additional structures. The important thing is this temple has got its own significant architectural beauty, elegance and calculations. It is totally different from the temples built by Pallavas, even by Rajasimha Pallava, the Kailasanatha temple, Shisho temple, Mamallapuram, and the Bhairathas. There are many temples built before this temple, but anyway, this temple has got its own peculiar kind of structural elements in the architecturally built temple. We have to see. See, this is the Sobhana having types of steps reaching to the deity in the Kandahamya of the southern direction. That Sobhana has got Saraswati, Vagdevi and the facing of the Sobhana. The same kind of structures are visible on all other sides also. When coming towards this Adhishtanam and Upapitam, this is called Upapitam. See, up to this point, this is Upapitam, and above this, up to that point, there is Adhishtanam. In the Vastu Sastra, there are two kinds of Adhishtanas available. Adhishtanam is nothing but basement. One is Pada Bhadram, and another one is Pradi Bhadram. So, this temple has got two varieties of, both varieties of Adhishtanam in this temple. This is a peculiar Adhishtanam we can find here. This is the first time in the history, full-fledged Varga Beta what we call. This combination of two Adhishtanas having a whole temple in one Adhishtanam portion is called Varga Beta. Before this temple, Nandi Varma introduced this kind of Varga Beta in his temple in Uthiramerur itself, in Sabha Mandapam. But this temple is a full-fledged and well-defined Varga Beta who Dandi Varma introduced at this temple. See, this is the bottom portion is called the Adhishtanam Jagati and the other one is Kumudam and Grivam Patika as the features of this Pada Bhadra Adhishtanam. Whereas this Adhishtanam is called Pradi Bhadra Adhishtanam. Pradi Bhadra Adhishtanam is seen that octagonal that Kumudam is changes into circular Kumudam and that Patti is changing into Yala portion. Whereas this Jagati is changing at from the point Padma Jagati. See the combinations of two Adhishtanams at one temple and one Adhishtanam. This is called Bhagya Betam. This is a very peculiar Padma Sankhita elaborately discussing about this Bhagya Beta varieties in the temple. So this is the important thing. Started from this temple. Evolution of Adhisthana reached up to the Vijayanagara Samrajya. Vijayanagara built this Koodalalaga temple in Madurai. That temple, if you see the Adhisthana of the Koodalalaga temple, you can see the culmination of this Vatka Veta Varedi Adhisthana, having got elaborate treatment and done in Adhisthana. Many inscriptions, out of which very important Pallava inscription is very important to note here. That inscription is here. This inscription is written by Pallava king Dandivarma during 9th century. The lipi, the language is Pallava Grantham. The inscription says, Swastri Sri Asya Alankara Malamcha Yata Lakshana Samyutam Yaha Kanchit Veti Sagalam Savaihi Vastavidam Paraka. What it is, what it says. This temple has been built with very significant calculations told in the Shilpa Shastras. That very significant calculations are being used in the temple, and the one who is expert in the Shilpa Shastras or Vastu Shastras are only able to identify actually what is this temple and what calculations are made for creating such a beautiful temple. This is the meaning of this inscription. This is the temple has got three tiers. Having Adhisthanam, the basement has got ornamental Adhisthanam in granite, and above all three floors are in brickwork. The special feature of this temple is nine deities are located in one temple. The nine deities, how it is being located. If you see the temples in Tamil Nadu and so many places, you can find only one shrine or one deity at the center, whereas it has nine deities. The placement of the deities has got different projections called the Sarvodopatram. Projections in all directions, all four directions. See, the projection is called Sarvodopatram. Sarvodo means all four sides. All the directions are having the projections. That is why it is called Sarvodopatram. One another word also, it is specifically mentioned for these kind of structures called Ashtanga Vibhanam. This Ashtanga Vibhanam, the same kind of temples are very less number of temples that we have. Now we come again, why these projections are having done. See, the Sarvodopatram, all four sides has got four deities and it has its own replicable inside. This temple has got staircase to reach the deities first and second floor. There are two varieties of staircase structure this temple has got. This kind of structure is constructed called the Anarkita structure. There are two kinds of structures in Vastu Shastras called Arpidam and Anarpidam. Anarpidam means there must be a space between external wall and internal wall to come around the structure and having staircase to reach the place. These kind of arrangements are made in the Anarpidam structures. Whereas Arpidam is without space between two walls, having one wall is called Arpidam. This temple belongs to the Anurthita kind of structure. Standing on the steps going towards second floor. See, this is the first floor and this is second floor. When we start from the ground floor, at the ground floor the deity is in standing posture, that is called sthanakam. Asanam is the sitting posture, that Mahavishnu is in sitting posture, is called asanam, which is in the first floor. And sayanam, it is the inclined posture of Mahavishnu. He is on the second floor. It is also very important to know the ground floor. There are what I already told you about Sarvadopatram. And in other words, the Sarvadopatram is also called Kandaharnyam. All the Kandaharnyam structures are having deities inside. Satyam, Achyutam, Aniruddham are the three deities standing in all three directions of the temple at the ground floor. Now we are standing on the top floor of the Sundara Varadaraja Perumal temple. Here we can see the tomb structure above this floor, and this is the one of the best temples in Tamil Nadu, having got 9 deities and staircases to reach the tires are the very important features to note, and it is the one of the beautiful temples in Tamil Nadu. This is the temple having rare qualities of architecture and sculpture, having 9 deities and 9 garbhakakas in one temple, is called the Sarvadopatram temple in Uthiramerur. This is the temple everyone should visit and learn lot of architectural information available at this temple, and protect this temple for generations. This is Dakshinamoorthy Sthapati for Culture Speaks.